Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another episode of Possum. Today, my name is Bandit, and today I've got
Ninja
and
Flash.
And today, we're talking about something that I think a lot of furries can relate to because, you know, we all have lived in different areas. Sometimes we've stayed in one spot our whole life, sometimes we go to a different place. So we're talking about living on the move, and this one's especially, I guess it's a bit more personal because it's like Ninja, for example, you're actually moving in April, so. I kind of talked about it in the episode, but I mean, have you always lived in Temecula your whole life, or have you been in other places too?
Well, I moved to Paris, and then I moved to, Paris, California, not Paris, France, obviously, but Paris, the ghetto Paris, whatever, and also I lived in Menifee, but that's still all within, like, half-hour radius, so.
So in the ghetto Paris, did they, like, you know,
snipers sitting at the top of the Eiffel Tower?
And they're like, you know, they're like put like snail down, make throwing snails at you.
Yeah, they definitely have the snails and they throw them atop the, you know, like Shell gas station.
S car go more like S car slow because you're a snail.
Andre, what about you? You said born and raised in Bellflower, or did you live in other places before that?
No, I lived many places. I started off in Jamestown, California, moved down to Whittier, and then moved over to Bellflower after living in another place in Whittier. After Bellflower, I came down in South Bay.
So now you live in Torrance.
Mm-hmm.
Last time we had someone leave California was Daniel, and when he was on Possum, he was actually still in Louisiana. Now he's back in California. So, it was just like, I know, like you said, it was very expensive, Ninja, when you said you were, like, leaving, and just, like, when did you decide, like, was that, like, a last resort, or were you guys trying to find other places to live and not want to have to go out of state?
You know, it was kind of something that we had talked over for, you know, a while now, and it's just, you know, up until this point, like, we tried moving, having roommates, and just, in Tennessee, we can have our own place, and, you know, just kind of, like, just have our own place and get our lives on the road, where we feel like we haven't, you know, been doing that out here.
Yeah, I mean, I've never really known how difficult it is for families to have to relocate, or when it, you know, it's just a person, or when it's a couple, because it's like, when your entire life has been situated in one place for so long, it's kind of hard to think of, like, where exactly am I going to, if I have to start all over again, I have to meet new people, it's going to be hard to keep in touch with people I already knew, because I already know if I start working, I'm not going to be able to talk to them as much as I wanted to.
That's true. But I'm also thinking of all the people that are, like, grumpy around me that I've had to deal with every day, and I get to leave them behind, and I'm just like, yes.
Flash, what kind of advice would you have for people who have never moved out of, like, an area that they're, like, they call home? Something that they're, like, moving, like, hundreds of thousands of miles away. What kind of advice would you give to people who have to go through that?
Don't hop on the Amtrak. It's the only train that charges me.
I don't know. It's growing your life. It's an expanding chapter to your life. Doesn't mean that the past is going to be gone. It just means that you have a future that's opening ahead.
Yeah, I want to come and visit California when I can, just to see everybody. You know, all my friends and my family, of course. You know, but for the most part, probably, you know, we'll stay in Tennessee for quite a while. And it's probably going to be a while before I'll be able to afford to come to California to visit. So everybody's starting, like, they have different paths they take. And you have to do what's right for you and do what makes you happy. And it's not that those people are forgotten or anything. It's just, you know, you guys are doing different things.
What color do you think of when you hear Tennessee? Because I think of orange.
I don't know. Brown, because it's... I don't know why brown.
Any type of desert sports team has the color orange in it, so I always think of orange.
That's true, but it's really green in Tennessee, so I don't know.
Who are we going to count on to, like, bring their cute little dog to all the fur meets and such? I mean, we can't pet it because it's working, but I mean, you know.
Oh, I'll share them on, like, Facebook or something with you. I am still scared. I have never lived outside of California, so it's a big step, but it's like... kind of go big or go home kind of thing.
I think you'll enjoy Tennessee. I heard they have shoes there.
That's where we're going to cut it off today. Just another reminder, if you guys want to be on an episode of Possum, we will occasionally reach out to the community, whether you're an artist or just another member of the community, or if you're an entertainer of some sort, artist kind of covers like music and drawing and all that crap. So yeah, check out our homepage on the raccoonsden.com. There's like a, it's like on the homepage, you can click on there to apply. Gives you all the details on what happens when you apply for it, like what the eligibility details are and whatever. So yeah, check that out. It's all for now, so we'll see you guys next time. Bye weekly, as always.
Bye.